mind. So please listen, and then we'll bring them out for you to meet. Thank you. As far as she was concerned, they were not part of the pack. that same time, one of our other females did see the need. And she actually adopted those babies and raised them up like they were her own. Would you guys like to meet the babies? Yes? All right. Well, I'm going to put Lakota away because guess what? She still doesn't like them. Probably never will. Okay, Lakota. In your background. Do they look like babies?
No.
Well, they're not cubs, obviously, but they are youngsters. These guys are all about a year, year and a half old. They're going to continue growing for another couple of years, 2 to 3 years. Wolves grow quickly the first year, and that's for survival. Physically, they grow quickly. Mentally, not so much. That takes a while longer. That's why they stay with the pack so long. Now these guys, what we have here are two boys and a girl. That was a little messy. Come on. Jump. There you go. Good job. Yes. Their names are Timber, Lobo, and Star. And right now we're just kind of playing with them to see what their abilities are going to be. You know, animals, just like people, you know, you don't train wolves. You find things that they like to do, and then we hope that they'll do it when we ask them. That doesn't always work out that way either. Now, we show them behaviors like this, really for their enrichment. You know, it's not nice that they have to be in a cage all the time. So we try to find things, stimulating things, for them to do, for their mind, and of course their physical abilities. And let's see who's going to do this. I already knew it was going to be Timber. Whoops. There we go. We call this rolling out the barrel. And it does take a certain amount of agility for him to do this. Good job, Timber. But I'm not handing it to them with my bare hand. I either put it on what we call the treat stick, or I throw it up in the air and they catch it. Wolves have more teeth than a domestic dog, and their jaw strength is twice that of a pit bull. They have about 1,500 pounds of pressure in that jaw. And that, of course, is one of the reasons that they are such efficient hunters. Don't we use the treats to, of course, encourage them to do different behaviors? I don't know if you noticed that the treats they're getting is raw meat. And these guys eat about 5 pounds of raw meat every day. And that's each one of them. So you know what our grocery bill is. All right. Once again, it's Timber. Good job, Timber. Slowly. Sorry, Timber. Come on. And then sometimes the problem is getting them to stop. We get started here and we can't get them to stop. Timber, I think they've got the idea now. You're going up and over. Good job. Thank you, Timber. Stop now. All right, maybe if you guys would just give him a little more applause. There we go. Whoops. Where are you? Good job. Thank you, Timber. Good boy. Yes, you're a good boy, Timber. Even the sleek Lobo gets in the treats and didn't do anything. They learned that real quick, didn't they? 2% of Alaskan Malibu mixed in there. And personally, my thought is that really makes us a totally different animal here. He's definitely not any more domesticated. These guys will fight at the drop of a coin, so to speak. In a wolf pack, that doesn't happen. They expect, not many, I guess, they respect the owner, the alpha, and everybody listens to what he or she has to say, and nobody questions it. These guys are in little arguments all the time, as you can hear by the noise that goes on. All right, everybody's in their place. It's so pretty. Let's hear it for the pack. Aren't they beautiful? Yes, you boys. Thank you, guys. Well, they're here in one place. We'll introduce them to you. Down here on the end is Juno. Next to Juno is Yukon. On the very top is Alaska. And next to Alaska, on the other end, having a little bit of a hard time containing himself, is little Pimo. And we call them all the boys. And we do think they're beautiful. What do you guys think? Did you know that the wolf is one of only three species of animal in the whole world that cares for the elderly? That's right. If there's older ones in the pack that can't hunt anymore, the others will bring food back for him. If there's one that's sick or injured, they'll take care of them. Whoops. They're truly amazing. They deserve our respect. And right now they need our help. But let's hear it for Alaska. He's doing great here. Yes. Yes, they are in trouble right now. The wolves, I don't know if you knew about it, but out west they have taken them off the protected list. And they're now open season on them. They can kill as many as they want, no limits. I'm not against responsible hunting. I'm not against responsible hunting, but I am against eliminating a whole species of animal. And that's what they want to do out there. They don't want any more predatorial animals. And that's not a good thing. They really help our environment. They help other animals to have a better place to live. So it's important for us to take care of them. So if you have the opportunity, if you can talk to somebody that has some power or some, you know, decision making, and I dare say you won't see this done by the wolf again. So if you have your cameras, now's the time to get them out.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
You know, wolves have a great sense of concentration and focus. That's another reason that they are such good hunters. We're going to ask one of our wolves to walk up these planks and go across those two little pipes you see up there. They're about 3/4 of an inch in diameter. Let's see if we can get Juno to do it one more time today. You have to get this just right, or you won't do it. There you go, Juno. Come on. Ready? Until he gets back. evening here at the show. May God bless you, and God bless America. Woo! Thank you. Now, it's really not the end of the show. If you'd like to go inside, see all the wolves up close, take pictures. We have a very rare, well, not so rare, but a very beautiful Arctic wolf inside. It didn't come out for the show. He's brand new to us. We've only had him about two weeks. So he's not ready to come out here yet. But you can go inside and see him. He's quite a sight to behold. And we do ask for a dollar donation for that opportunity. So if you'd like to do that, please line up over here by the souvenir. Luna is an 8-month-old, half timber, half Arctic, little girl wolf. Yes. Isn't she beautiful? We've got a very different coloration here with that cross, that Arctic timber cross. Now, the story with her is that she came to us as a single wolf. We don't usually get just one wolf at a time. They usually come in a group, at least a pair. She came all by herself. What did that mean? She has no friends. And nobody really has accepted her in a big group yet. We'll work on that, and possibly as time goes by, she will find a friend in there. But meanwhile, she needed a friend, a companion. You know, wolves are pack animals. They're not used to being by themselves. So we have Luna's little friend. It's kind of her security blanket, but yes, isn't she cute? This is Daisy, and she is a Chihuahua. We call her the very rare Mexican gray wolf, but in reality, she is a Chihuahua. And you know what? She gives Luna the confidence that she needs to be happy. And she goes with us wherever Luna goes, Daisy goes. So yeah, so if you'd like to come on inside, we got our gates are open. Line up over there. It is a dollar to come inside. Go right into the den. Check out the other wolves. Check out Ola, our Arctic wolf, and the rest of them. And then you can come on out. And if Luna wants to say hello to you, you can give her a little pat. But we kind of let her decide that. And there's a, you know, a special way to approach people on the side. And when you come out, you can say hello to your student here in Daisy. But when you do come out, when you do want to see Luna, big thing is do not approach her face on. Don't look at her in the eyes. Straight in the eyes. That's a challenge for any wild animal. And just catch her a little bit in the back or the side port, the side hip. Not on her head. Everybody wants to go right for the face. And that's not a good thing with a wolf.
Yes.
Step up.
$1 per person. Thank you, sir.
Oh.
There you go.
Thank you. How many?
You have to pay attention.
Oh, thank you very much. Thank you.
I'm going to say hello to the wolf.
Okay.
Yeah, right. Don't run into her.
I thought you were going
to. No, I was going to.
Give her a little pat here on the back end. Yeah. Let her sniff you.
Want to try?
She seems to like you. That's good. That's good.
We're going to open up this other door. The exit is over here.
Yeah. There you go. Daisy, where are you going, Daisy? Come here.
There you go. I have a pin that reminds me a lot of Daisy.
Does she? Yes. Not on
the
head.
Is it like dog?
Not
on the head.
There you go.
So they're not dogs, yeah? They're wolves.
They're wolves, that's right.
Looks like dogs.
No, it's the dog that looks like them.
No,
not
like
the wolf that looks like a dog.
You.
Yeah.
Your little pet right here.
What's your name again?
Luna.
Bye, Luna. Bye.
In the wild, they can eat her, yeah?
Oh, yeah.
Easily.
Oh,
Хочешь, подойди, погладь.
Thank you.
О, это сюрприз.
О, это волк, если бояться.
Face on thing because that's a definite
Volky.
Challenge. Oh. And then if there is something that triggers something in there, some smell.
I've had a bad experience.